عرفت الهوى مد عرفت الهوى عرفت الهوى مد عرفت الهوى وأغلقت قلبي على من عاداك وأغلقت
اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانه القوي الغالب مالك كل شيء له ملك سبحانه وتعالى لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير. الله سبحانه وتعالى owns everything, decides everything, do everything, whether we believe it or not, whether we feel it or not. If we don't have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who can we trust? If you don't trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you cannot trust anybody, you cannot trust even yourself. And good or bad will happen if you accept what happens. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy from you and grant you everything you desire for. If you are not accepting what happens, you cannot do anything about it. And you will be sad, and you will get nothing, and you lose also ar-rahma and the ridwan, the acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we don't accept what Allah does to us or make to us, what can we do about it? Nothing. We cannot do anything about it. It's not in our hand to change the will of Allah. It's not in our hand to change our destiny. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decide to do, we'll do. Whether we like or we dislike. Arkan al-Iman is 6. Arkan al-Iman. First, Arkan al-Islam is 5. The one does not become Muslim until obey these 5 Arkan. What is Arkan al-Islam? It is something you do, you speak, you perform. This is Arkan al-Islam. Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. 1. By your tongue. And you have to believe it in your heart. That there is no God but Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his messenger, his Rasul, he sent him to us to teach us. The second, Iqamu salah. We have to perform the salawat 5 times per day. As Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have told us and taught us. The third, Ita'u zakah. We pay the zakah on time. And when we pay our zakah money, we don't feel any minna, any gratitude when we pay to the poor. We don't think that we have done any favor to him. It is from Allah. Allah had ask us to do it. So this money we are giving does not belong to us. It is zakah from Allah to the poor people. We give it without feeling any gratitude that we have done something good. No. We have done only what we are supposed and what we should do. It is zakah. Sawm Ramadan, which has to fast Ramadan. حج بيت الله من استطاع إليه سبيلا. If you can make حج, you can afford حج, you make the حج. Affording حج by 2 things. You can afford, you have the money to go to perform حج, and you have the money to leave your family back home. You cannot go حج and take your money and leave the family back home, cannot have food, cannot go around. You say, I'm going for حج. You are not allowed to go حج. If the family back home is not have enough funds and money to carry on in the time you are absent, especially if they depend on what you bring or what you give them. When you are paying zakah, Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us, Al-Yadul Uliya khayru min al-Yadul Sufla. What means Al-Yadul Uliya? The higher hand is better than the lower hand. The lower hand is the receiving hand. The higher hand is the giving. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us, this money you are giving, whether sadaqah or zakah, put in your mind, it fills in Allah's hand before it fills in this poor man's hand. What we are giving, Allah is receiving before this, the poor man who is receiving from me. So, be humble when you give it, be grateful, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He allows you to give. And thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He did not make you the one to receive. This is minna from Allah. This is generosity from Allah to you that make you give and not receive. Arkan al-Iman, after, if you do that, you are Muslim, but not mu'min. The mu'min is higher than the mu'min. The mu'min is much higher than the Muslim. Arkan al-Iman 6, and it is by heart and by strong belief. أن تؤمن بالله, you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You believe He's there, He's watching, He's with you all the time. He know what you are saying, He know what you are thinking, He know what you want to do before you do it. Wherever you go, wherever you hide, He is with you all the time. When you have this feeling in your heart, you will be conscious of the existence of Allah in your heart. You cannot do wrong. You cannot say bad because Allah is watching you. When that is in your heart, mashallah, you really become true mu'min. Tu'min billah. This is iman billah. Iman billah that He is the supreme. He is controlling everything in your life, small and big. He controls all this earth. He controls everybody. He controls the thought of everyone. He can do what He wish without asking permission from anybody. He is the creator. He is our master. And after that, He is with us all the time. He does not take from Malaika or somebody just report of what you are doing. This lady or this man did and that. No, he sees himself. And also he take report. He take report, why? Is written, you have two malak. Everyone have two malak, raqib wa atid, watching him and recording. They are recording everything you do, everything you say. The malak in yameen is written good things. Malak in yasar, he recording your bad things. When you're about to say bad thing or commit a sin, the malak in yameen tell to the malak of yasar, don't write. Maybe he will repent. Maybe he will say astaghfirullah. If you say astaghfirullah, he will not write it. The malak of yameen is opposite. Whenever you think of doing something good, he will write it. If you do it, it will be written 10 times. 10 times hasanat. When you think of doing hasana, is counted for you 1. When you do it, is counted for you 10. But when you think of doing sayya, it's not counted. When you do it, it's counted for you 1. That's how generous Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with us. Imanu billah. This is means full trust in Allah. You cannot have iman billah with half trust. Everything you want, ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything you wish, ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything you hate, ask Allah to make it go away and you avoid it. If you have somebody near you and you said, please give me one tissue, the tissue box is away. He said, tfaddal, he give you one. And then you said next time, please give me one tissue, he give you. The third time he said, off, why you don't take it yourself? Even though it didn't cost him anything. If you ask him just some earth or something from the garden, it is too much for him. We, by our nature, get bored when we are asked to do. Maybe one time, okay, next time, the third time, we get fed up. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you to ask Him once and again and again and again. And He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُلِحِينَ فِي الدُّعَاءِ. When you nag and when you ask Allah strongly, He loves more. Allah tell us, أَدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Make dua and I استجب لكم. And He tell us, رسول الله, أَدْعُوا اللَّهَ حَتَّى لِمِلْحَ الطَّعَامِ. يعني even, don't say I will make dua only for big things. I want to make dua for matters big. No. Ask dua for even the smallest thing. Even if you want salt for your food, Ya Allah, please arrange for me to have salt. If you have, this is from hadith, أسأل الله ولو ملح الطعام or حبل the lace of your shoes. Is cut, you want another lace. So it's very simple. It's simple rope. You ask Allah. Get yourself accustomed to ask all your needs, small or big, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Get your tongue accustomed to make dua for your children, always. Always ask Allah to give them hidayah, to give them barakah, to make them ulama, to make them good people in the society, effective. If your son, you want him to be a doctor, Ya Allah, please, make him be a smart doctor, not just a doctor. Make him be a very professional doctor. Ya Allah, I want my son to be a very good professional engineer. And always with salah, min al-salihin. He can be a very good doctor and not salih. That's bad. He can be a good engineer and bad habits and not salih. No. Aj'alhu Allahumma min al-salihin, min al-muhtadin. With the profession you want. Why? Because he may be a good doctor and a bad with his parents. They ask him for something. I don't have time. I have meeting. Please come. We just want to see you. We haven't seen you for so long. He's been working, mashallah. I don't have time. Anybody who is disobedient and not loving to his parents, Allah will not make him have a good life in dunya, not in akhirah. And all his work is fully unaccepted. He pray, he do charity, he read Quran, all in vain, not counted. First thing to be obedient and loving and soft-hearted with the parents. Mother especially and father. A mother especially and father. Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man asked him, Ya Rasulullah, man ahabbul nasa bi sahabati? Who is deserve my companionship better in my life? Who should I accompany and talk and be always with him? He said, your mother. He said, after that who? He said, your mother. After that who? Your mother. Three times your mother. The fourth time he asked, he said, your father. The mother, mashallah, in our religion and Islam has a very, very, very high regard. And very have, if when he said, mashallah, I love Allah, I trust Allah, I depend everything with Allah, but he is bad with his parents. He's a big liar. He does not trust Allah. He does not believe in Allah because he's not doing what Allah have ordered him. Allah in his book in Quran tell us, وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Worship Allah and don't have company to him. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. With your parents, you have to have ihsan. Good. The word ihsan means good treatment in every aspect. And in other ayah, Allah said, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah have decreed, made it a law. You only worship him and بِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Be good to your parents. Have ihsan with your parents. If somebody He's doing everything, mashallah, good, successful life, but not good with his parents. He's not getting anything. At the end, he will have su'ul khatima. Su'ul khatima, inshallah. Su'ul khatima means he will be swayed and swingled, and then he will leave Islam totally. And we must all remember. Birru aba'akum, tabirrukum abna'akum. If you have birr and ihsan to your parents, your children will have birr to you. You are bad with your parents, your children will be worse with you. Worse. Not like you were dealing with your parents, much worse than you were dealing with your parents. And you remember, people put their old parents in old people homes. Tell them, you will be put in old people homes. Just wait, your time will come. And maybe worse home than you are putting your parents in. You are maybe visiting your parents when you put in the old people home once a month, maybe they will visit you once a year. كَمَا تَدِينُ تُدَانُ As you do will be done upon you. And this rule is for parents, for work, for friendship, for everything. كَمَا تَدِينُ تُدَانُ How you want people to treat you, treat them. How you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treat you, behave with Him like that. If you have full love and trust in Allah, look in your heart. Not what we say by mouth, look it in your heart. You have high regard to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. High regard means what? Means you are afraid to make sin. Afraid to do something Allah said don't do. Always in Islam, the don'ts is more important to obey than the do's. When Allah says don't, it means don't at all. Not little, not much. Not small, not little, not by any means. But when He says do, أعملوا ما استطعتم. Do by the amount you can bear, by the amount you can manage. You don't have to overdo yourself. You don't have to kill yourself. You don't have to get yourself so tired. No, do with generosity and with simplicity so it can be continuous. خير الأعمال ما دام. The best thing is what it continues. Not one day you sit down and make sunnah prayer 100 rak'ah and the other day you don't pray. That's it. Madam means whatever you do, even little, continues. Allah ordered us to do the fruit. This we have to do it without minna. Whatever said in Arkan al-Islam. This is must. After that, we do al-sunan, al-nawafil. Allah is more satisfied and He loves for us to do what He ordered. This is, if we do what He ordered, He loves that best. After that, Allah wants us to do the nawafil. Hadith Sharif, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hadith Qudsi says, مَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه فإذا أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر بها ويده التي يبطش بها ورجله التي يمشي بها ولئن سألني لأعطينه ولئن استعاذني لأعيذنه Allah is talking in Hadith Qudsi Allah is talking by the word of Rasulullah It's not Quran Quran are the words of Allah directly Hadith Qudsi, the word of Rasulullah from Allah. Allah is telling him to tell us by his expression of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This Hadith Qudsi, Allah telling us, مَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءَ أَحَبُّ لَيَا مَفْتَرَضْتُ Abdi, we are Abid Allah. Abdi is us. Never come, try to be close to me with something more loving to me, more desire to me than what I have made it compulsory to him, than what I have requested. So the first thing, we do fard. Now somebody go to the charity and make sanawafil and make siyam and he missed the fard prayer. He said, this is all not accepted. First fard, al-furud. Al-furud, what is compulsory. Birr al-walidain, ahsan al-walidain, fard, not sunnah. What means birr al-walidain? Ahsan al-walidain. To be good to your parents is fard, compulsory to us. Allah says in this other. So in this other hadith, Allah says to the man who is good to his parents, do whatever you want. I have forgiven you. It means whatever he do sins, Allah will make him repent and istighfar, and Allah forgive him. Anything concerned with Allah, Allah is forgiving. And he says to the man who is bad to his parents, talk bad, treat them bad, not being kind to them, cut them, not visit them. He said to him, Allah said, مَهْمَا فَعَلْتَ فَلَنْ أَغْفِرَ. Whatever you do, I will not forgive you. It means all his work is useless and it will not get him anywhere. Not counted, finished. وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. Means all the work they have done, we make it go in air, fry. Nothing count of it. So we don't come and attend majlis ilm and do ilm and do zikr and do, and we are bad with our parents. And when our parents say, please come, I want to see you. No, I'm going to majlis ilm. Going to your parent to make them happy is better for you than going to majlis ilm. One of the Sahaba came to Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to go for jihad. I want to go fight kuffar. Send me with the soldier. And Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked him, do you have parents that still live? He said, yes. You have, do they have other children than you? He said, no, I am the only one. What do they say about you going for jihad? He said, they are sad and angry. And Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, فَفِيهِمَا فَجَاهِدْ. Go make jihad with them. Your jihad is with your parents. جُلُوسَكَ عَلَى السَّرِيرِ مَعْهُمَا تُضْحِكْهُمَا وَيُضْحِكَانَكَ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْجِهَادِ. Means you sitting on bed with your parents, make them laugh and happy, is better than you going for jihad fi sabilillah. So being good is better than majlis ilm, is better than anything else.